What up, peeps? Tony Baker here, back with another review. This time I'm reviewing Stranger Things Season 3 on Netflix. We all know about Stranger Things. It's one of Netflix's most popular series. And it's back. You know, 11 and the gang are back. They just keep getting into trouble with these interdimensional, you know, monsters. He won't leave these kids alone, man. Leave these kids alone. Leave our dimension alone. Stop coming over here. You know what I'm saying? He's always around.
Yeah, I'm gonna get these kids. I'm gonna get these kids.
Leave these kids alone. Let them be kids. Sick of these monsters from another dimension. Don't you just get tired of monsters from another dimension? You trying to just, you know, navigate your life through, you know, junior high? Hey, you got to worry about monsters and your nose bleeding? Shout out to 11, man. It's got to suck. Every time you use your powers, your nose bleeds. It seems like it hurts. Oh, my bad, y'all. I don't know about y'all, but my nose hadn't bled in a long time. That alone, I'd be like, I can't keep doing this. You know what I mean? Oh, man. Cast is great as usual. It's funny seeing these kids grow. Because it's like, man, they were babies when they first started. Now they voices cracking. They fully bearded. 11 had a beard and a mustache in this. She is grown out here. I'm like, man. I noticed season 2 of Stranger Things, it was good. It was heavy, though. It was like, man, emotional toll. And what I've noticed, and part of the appeal of Stranger Things is how it's purposely tailored for 80s kids, which is what I am. So it's geared, I'm the audience for Stranger Things. Like, it takes you back to the 80s when it was like kids in movies battling monsters and running and working together as a team. And that was the initial, even down to the font of the Stranger Things logo, the music is very 80s, which I appreciate, because that was, I love movies my whole life, and I get it. And so season 2 got a little heavy for me. And I noticed in season 3 they lightened it up. The tone is much lighter in season 3. It's a lot of jokes. They ramped up the comedy in season 3. Yeah, you get those heavy moments, but it's not as heavy as season 2. Even Winona Ryder's transition, because in season 1, she was a wreck. You know, she killed it on the acting tip, but of course, her son is missing. She was a wreck. And I still feel like that first season was amazing. And now, you know, her son is back, so she, you know, they cracking jokes, you know what I'm saying? Everybody's just real silly in this. And you still get the action, they running around, and good character development. Like, to make me care about a Russian scientist character that was just introduced in this season, I'm like, I like this guy. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that really matters. And of course you care about the kids and stuff like that, but I just feel like they ramped up the fun in this one. But I will say this, they only, you know, kept it to 8 episodes, not 10. So, you know, short and sweet. But even though it was short and sweet, I was still kind of like, after a while, I got to the point where I was just like, all right, let's wrap this up. Not the show as a whole, but just the season. I'm like, all right, let's wrap this up. I found myself getting kind of like, you know, antsy just for the wrap up. Like, all right, let's finish this, okay? And you know, this time the monster used a new host, which was Billy. You know, it was introduced in season 2. He was the host. And Billy was a character that, you know, I'd never really grown to like. He was cool, but it wasn't like I was attached to him. That's one of the strong points of Stranger Things. Like, they had the gift of making you change your mind about certain characters, like throughout the series. Like, you'd be like, oh, this guy's a jerk. And then once they're involved in the mission and what's going on, you'd be like, you know what, he's not so bad. That's what I always liked about it. But with Billy, it's just pretty boy, you know what I'm saying, kind of a jerk to his sister or whatever. So it was just like, eh, you know what I'm saying? So when he got possessed, I was like, all right, you know what I'm saying? Whatever happens, happens. So, but I was just kind of ready for it to wrap up, you know? Even though it was already a shortened season, I was just like, all right, let's finish it. With that, I got to make it lose points because I wasn't fully invested all the way through. I was just kind of like, all right, hurry up, guys. And then, so I felt myself thinking that. And so it has to lose points there. So, still got to go with season 1 as my favorite season of Stranger Things. But we got to review this season. And here's my review right here. Oh, yeah. I'm giving Stranger Things season 3, 3.5 saxophones out of 5. What if when I turned around, I had a bloody nose? And he'd be like, yo, Tony got mental powers out here. But really, I just had bad circulation. All right, peeps, that's my review of Stranger Things season 3. Let me know what you thought of season 3. in the comment section below. Let me know, what was your favorite season too? Let me know in the comment section below. Who's your favorite character? Let me know, who's my favorite character? That's a great question, man. I mean, we all know the fan favorite. Dustin is a good time. I feel like he was kind of missing in action a little too much at first. Then he came around. And I will say this, Lucas's little sister was super funny. She was rolling with Dustin. She was funny. And the fact, when she came to the realization that she too was a nerd, genius, man. I loved it. I loved that little element of it, man. Let me know in the comment section below what you thought of Stranger Things 3, man. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and as usual, we out here.